Hello, today we're looking at Reborn OS 2018-09-17 is the release name. So it's very obvious, very long name. And it's based on arts, which I like. And it's also, it's based on arts you get when you install the thing. You have so many options. You can choose between desktop environments, apps you want to install, and many other features. So I just went for the stock apps and I went for the ApriCity desktop environment. By default is Deepin, but we all know Deepin, and ApriCity OS was a very great looking OS, which they sadly took off because they didn't want to continue it, but Reborn took the desktop environment and made it alive again. It's fantastic. And what I found interesting is when you open it up for the first time, you get this little option to add a Flatpak repository into your system. As you can see, it is GNOME, but I also got all the other desktop environments, and it's GNOME 3.30. So you get the latest. The software center is super fast, which is not always the fit with GNOME in software. So if you go here and type in KDN Live, you will see you basically have everything. You have the latest version and it works out of the box. And if you go to software, you can see that you got your software repos. FlatUp is enabled because we enabled it. And then also, as you can see, it's still running, and you can also have automatic updates. It's a fantastic option. So I'm just gonna minimize this. I like that it got the minimize option, which sometimes GNOME doesn't have all the time. I'm gonna remove this from startup, otherwise it's little notification will start up every time when you open desktop. Desktop settings is just your normal stock GNOME settings, and I'm not gonna look too much into it. The files 3.30 is with all the new features of files. It's not like Ubuntu keeps back because I want desktop icons, so yes, no desktop icons. You can only have files start, not folders like in Fedora. So if you have, let's say you have a folder or create a folder, you don't have the option to start it. Which is a bit interesting, but if, let's say for instance, let's try to see if LibreOffice is not pre-installed, but let's go for a text editor. And we just create a little document. Empty and save, so we don't go crazy with lots of information. You can start it also, so maybe just like web documents. I don't understand why I can't use the start button, but in any case, I like their option here to run updates automatically. Normal GNOME settings here, you got your individual places menu and you got the application menu, which is just a basic classic looking menu with your activities overview, which is normally here, there. So that's good. And then you, I don't know why it's pending still. And if you don't like the software center of GNOME, you also got the arts repo. And yes, a lot of beautiful apps here, like you got your arts Linux kernel, a very easy way to update your kernel is here. It shows you what current kernel you have, kernel 4.18. And then you can also update your kernel to whatever you want. If you want an older version, or if you want whatever you want of the kernels. The latest, if it's not available yet by default, you can go for it. And as I said, you got your Qt5 settings, You got some Reborn, you got your GNOME Tweaks pre-installed. It's a very complete operating system. And it works well because the arts theme jumping up and down inside here, and it's really beautiful. And as I said, you got your app software updater you can run like this, and then also you got the system utilities others, you got your normal arts repo which we want in our arts systems. So if your GNOME software center doesn't work, arts repo works and it's beautiful and in the out of the box goodness. If you got the system monitor, and that's the last thing we will do in the system. As you can see, it runs at about 1.2 gigabytes of RAM. That's quite a lot, and also quite a lot of CPU power, but it is a GNOME issue, unfortunately. And yeah, everything otherwise, it's just a very nice operating system, and as you can see, everything works. Let's try Cadian Life again. Say we want to install it, apply it. Choose. Close. Commit. Password. Authenticate, and as you can see, it's all starting to run, so I know it works out of the box with this system. One thing I noticed, the lock screen seems to not work, but otherwise everything works. Thank you for watching, see you later. I really think it's fantastic that you got Apricity back into a Linux-based operating system, and Reborn is a classic arts enjoyable, and as I said, there's many desktop environments you choose from. It's not just this one. And if you want for arts, this is a great choice. Yeah, thank you for watching. See you later.